All right? Who's that man he's talking about? He's referring to Israel, man. All right? Ultimately, the elect. All right? But ultimately, Israel, but specifically speaking, the elect. All right? Because only the elect is going to make it out of here. All right? And from, and there's going to be,
what was it, 12,000
out of each tribe, man. Judah, Benjamin, Levi, Simeon, Zebulun, Ephraim, Manasseh, Gad, Reuben, Asher, Naphtali, and Issachar. 12,000 out of each tribe, all right, are going to get sealed, man. Which are, and those 12,000 represent the one-third, the elect. And the two-thirds are pretty much, you know, they're going to be done away with, man. They're going to, you know, they're going to have to die, man. All right, the scripture speaks about Israel being compared to the sand of the sea. Because there are, Israel is scattered amongst the Gentiles, you know, and there's going to be confusion of faces, man. So can you imagine being compared to the sand of the sea? Can you imagine how many Israelites are talking about? Can you imagine how much two-thirds are?
Millions.
That's a lot of Israelites, man. All right, so you could believe. So that's why the, that's what the scripture says, the slaughtering of the Lord shall be many. All right? Continue.
Verse 9. Then shall they be in pitiful case. I'm gonna read it again. Verse 9. Then shall they be in pitiful case.
That's right. Now, hold on with that. Now, then shall they be in a pitiful case. What does that mean? Well, for those who are not bound in this truth, who rejected Yahweh Shem Yahushai, they're gonna be in a pitiful case. All right? All these people are going to be in a pitiful case because they rejected Yahweh Shem Yahushai. And I'm talking to you Israelites, man. All right? Now you Edomites, man. All right? Smiling and walking on the streets.
It says, which now have abused my ways, and they that have cast them away despitefully shall dwell in torment.
Good. Now, what is the Lord saying right there? Well, Israel abused his ways by what? Following these false doctrines, man. Going after wisdom that is not in correlation to the true wisdom, which is found in the Bible, man, in the Holy Scriptures. We got Jakes in Islam. All these other fucking philosophies, man. All right? As a matter of fact,
It says, verse 10, for such as in their life have received benefits and have not known me, and they that have loathed my law while they yet had liberty, and when as yet place of repentance was opened unto them, understood not, but despised it.
Now, the Lord is saying that you Israelites, all right, there was room for, before there was room for repentance, but what? You hated the fact that, you know, you pretty much hated the Lord, man. That's the whole point of it. You pretty much hated the Lord. You did, you know, like I said, you followed all these false doctrines, all right? You broke the law. You know, you went off to the point where there was no room for repentance anymore, because the Heavenly Father got tired of you. The Heavenly Father got tired, man. All right? And that's why Yahweh Shai came on the scene. And that's why we live by faith today, man.
That's right.
All right? So, hey, man, this also proves to you that, like the scripture said, the Heavenly Father is, you know, he's pitiful and he has mercy, man. If it wasn't for Yahweh Shai, man, we wouldn't be saved. We would have been destroyed, man. Right, but by Yahweh's mercy through his son Yahweh Shai, and Yahweh means he is, Bashim means coming, Yahweh Shai means deliverer, all right? Yahweh Bashim, Yahweh Shai, he is coming in the name of the deliverer, man. So Yahweh Shai, or deliverer, because he came and he sacrificed himself as a lamb, all right? We are saved, man. We are given, we are bestowed mercy upon by the Heavenly Father, man. Because the only way we're gonna get to the Heavenly Father is through Yahweh Shai, man.
That's right.
All right? Yahweh Shai said, lo, I come in the volume of the book. It is written of me. All right? He said you also have to eat the whole roll. And when you eat the whole roll, you gotta expect it's gonna taste sweet. Because scripture said, how sweet are my words? Yea, it is sweeter than honey. It's gonna be sweet at first, but when you swallow it, it's gonna be bitter. And that bitterness represents the hell that we're gonna go through in this kingdom, man. Read verse 12. This is verse 12. The same must know it after death by pain.
Good, man. That's talking about two-thirds, man. All right?
So, like, that's one thing.
Two-thirds have to know death. They're going to know death by pain. Why? Again, they rejected the Heavenly Father, man. They were the ones that said, crucify him, man. All right? They were the ones that's pretty much like, you know what, man? You know, to hell with him, this and that. You know, they blasphemed the Lord's name. All right? And because they rejected Yahweh Shem Yahushai, they are also going to get rejected by him. And how is they going to get rejected by? By the arrows, all right? And those arrows represent the missiles, man, all right? And they're going to burn along with this kingdom, man, all right? And with that, you know, I'm going to end it off, you know, let the next brother come on and speak, all right?
Shalom, yeah, the Israelites, like the brother so beautifully put in the beginning of his sermon, we're going to go to the book of Sirach in the Apocrypha. You can show them the cover. This is part of the King James Bible. It's in the original 1611 authorized version of the Bible. So this was ordained by the Lord, this book we're reading. The book of Sirach, the second chapter. So that's one of our righteous forefathers, Sirach. You know, he was back in the ancient homeland, and he brought a lot of wisdom for our people in these days, you know what I'm saying? Because we're dealing with wisdom and knowledge and understanding of Yahweh Hashem, Yahweh Shah. I'd like to say that the word of Yahweh Hashem, Yahweh Shah will give us another opportunity to come out here and try to wake up our people, the Israelites, people listed on that sign, because this is what we must do to wash the blood off our hands, you know, because we are all sinners. We sin in our past lives. We broke the commandments and the laws. And Yahweh Shai, our Lord, you know, he's a black man from the tribe of Judah. He came to shed his blood for us, and he resurrected. He's sitting at the right hand of the Father. He wants us to come out here and gather our people. So we got the book of Sirach, chapter 2, verse 1. Sirach is also known as the book of Ecclesiastes.
So this is Sirach, chapter 2, verse 1. My son, if thou come to serve the Lord.
Yeah, my son. Sirach is talking to all the sons of Israel, you know what I'm saying? Judah, Benjamin, Levi, Ephraim, Issachar. So my son, if thou will, read it again.
My son, if thou will come to serve the Lord.
Serve the Lord, meaning keep the commandments in the name of Yahweh Shai, and be a servant, and come out here the highways and the byways as men, as men, and wake up your people. So read on, brother.
Prepare thy soul for temptation.
Yeah, the temptation of Babylon the Great, the temptation of all lands, with the false religions, Buddhism, Hinduism, all that garbage, you know what I'm saying? It's a temptation to our people. You know, lust, adultery, drug dealing, you know, robbing your brother for his sneakers, for his gold chain. That's the temptation, you know what I'm saying? It's all kinds of temptation in this earth. You know, we go down the list. So our righteous forefather, in the name of Yahweh Hashem, Yahweh Shad, is telling us, prepare thy soul for temptation. Read on.
Verse 2. Set thy heart aright.
Set thy mind aright. Set it aright. Meaning, keep the commandments. I have to keep repeating. Keep the commandments in the name of Yahweh Shah. That's the only way you're going to get right. And day by day, repent of your sins. Because we all sinners, we get killed every day because our thoughts. We're in a polluted land, you know what I'm saying? Constantly being barraged by negative influences and negative images, you know what I'm saying? We're walking amongst heathen. Israelites are not supposed to walk amongst heathen. No, we're princely people. We're kingly people, you know what I'm saying? We're the sons of Yahweh. In the name of Yahweh Shai, we're walking amongst the devil. You know what I'm saying? This is the lowest we've ever been in our existence as a people. So, you know, brother.
Continuing on, it says, and constantly endure.
Constantly endure. You gotta constantly endure, you know what I'm saying? You go off one day, you wake up, the next day, you repent. You repent, you go on your knees and repent. You face the east if you're in Babylon the Great. You repent to the Most High, you constantly endure, fight the negative thoughts, You know, there's always going to be people going to rise up. You know, your woman, your family, your boss, your co-workers, whatever it may be. People on the bus, the train, the traffic. You got to constantly endure. Because you don't want to be locked up in this prison. Because soon the RFID system is going to be implemented on you. So you don't want to be caught up in the prison system. Because those who are bond, it says those who are free and bond, they're going to get the microchip.
Right.
So you gotta constantly endure, because you don't want to deal with these devil judges and these devil cops, you know what I'm saying? You gotta pray the Most High constantly has a protection over you.
Right.
That don't mean you're not gonna catch hell. You just gotta constantly endure. So read on, brother.
It says, and make not haste in time of trouble.
Make not haste in time of trouble. So we got Jacob's trouble coming. Jacob's trouble is gonna be martial law. It's gonna be the economic collapse of the US dollar. So we're gonna have to endure when that trouble comes, you know what I'm saying? The food, water, but the Most High is going to provide for his servants, the prophets, the men of the Lord, starting with the apostles, the great millstone, the elders, the seer, Akim, spread throughout the whole earth. We're going to have to endure this trouble that's coming. We're in trouble in the hood, projects, the reservations, in South America, Central America, Caribbean. We're in constant trouble, but there's going to be more trouble. It's going to be called Jacob's trouble, the trouble of this nation, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, you can read that, yeah. The water.
This is the book of Jeremiah, chapter 30, verse 7. Alas, for that day is great.
That day is a time period. It's not just one day, it's a time period. The economic collapse of the United States dollar is going to cause the microchip system to be implemented, martial law, chaos on the streets, chaos, civil disruption, civil war, race war, you know what I'm saying? military on the streets. It's going to be that day. Gonna be a day of trouble.
Alas, for that day is great, so that none is like it.
None is like it. It's never gonna be a time like this. Because the greatest empire, as far as military might and riches and all that, America, is gonna fall. It's gonna fall. Babylon, it's falling. So read on, brother.
It says, so that none is like it.
None is like it, huh?
It is even the time of Jacob's trouble.
That's right, the trouble of our nation. So we have to go through that. We'll go back to Sabbath, we're gonna have to go through that trouble.
Well, let me end it off on the last one.
It says, but he shall be saved out of it.
That's right, he is located in Revelation, the 7th chapter. The 144,000 is the he that should be saved out of Jacob's trouble. The one-third is mentioned in Revelation, the 7th chapter, verse 9.
Okay.
Those are those who are gonna be saved out of it, you know what I'm saying? That's why we gotta constantly pray, Yahweh Hashem, Yahweh Shah, call upon those names, and ask them for deliverance, because we don't want to die in this country, in the famine, the race wars. We don't want to die in the concentration camps. Some of us will, some of the men of the Lord will die in concentration camps, as written in Revelation 2 and 10. So we're going to have to endure all those things. But it's a worthy death if it's going to come down to that. You know? It's going to have the names on your mouth, your mind, and your heart, your spirit. Yahweh Hashem, Yahweh Shah. Read on, brother.
This is Sirach. Back in Sirach chapter 2, verse 3. Cleave unto him
in the commandments. Cleave. You know, this is you have to break it down to the last common denominator with people, but cleave unto him, keep the commandments, keep the name of the Most High in your mind. Cleave unto him, constantly endure, do the works, come out here once a week, and call the people back. It's the marriage. The marriage of the Lamb.
Right.
People know about that. They've heard these words. A couple of days they're gonna go to about Easter. Sunday,
yep.
Yeah, Easter, so-called Easter Sunday. And everybody want to hear the word. What's the good word on that Easter Sunday? Nah, but this is the good word. But they're not teaching the truth. That's why they're pedophiles. That's why the Catholic Church has been shamed for all eternity for being faggots, you know what I'm saying? They don't even have women, you know what I'm saying? They don't even marry. So they're against the laws, because Levitical priests, they used to marry. They had to be a virgin, you know what I'm saying? So they bumped their head off. That's a satanic institution, the Vatican. They said it even means it goes back to something, a serpent. That the name Vatican goes back to like serpent, or basilica, or whatever. That's all demonic, with all the statues and all that. So we're reading the wisdom of the Bible. This is what we got to turn to. Not the Vatican, not the Catholic Church, not the Protestant Church, or obviously not Islam. So let's go back to that.
Cleave unto him and depart not away.
Depart not away. You might fall off. You might do something off, because we all sin. What is it?
It says, cleave unto him and depart not away.
Depart not away. Don't depart away, because that's the worst thing you can do. You're dealing with your soul.
Right,
you know what I'm saying? Yeah, they have them.
This is Proverbs 21:16, right? It says, man that wandereth out the way of understanding shall remain in the congregation of the dead, right? Okay, now back to what the brother was saying. All right, when you're in this truth, man, you can't allow yourself, all right, to be persuaded or influenced by the folly of the world, right? Because the Heavenly Father said, you are once children of the dark, but now you're children of the light. Right. All right. Be children of the light. Rough paraphrasing, man. All right. Right. Damned is he that comes into the body and falls back out, man. All right. Because this is serious business, man.
That's right.
All right. You can't come in this thing because, man, like I said, I like to bring this analogy out. When you come to this truth, all right, it's like you're signing a contract, man. All right. And when you put on this garment and you come out here, you're signing an even deeper contract. So you can't break that contract, man. If you break that contract, you're pretty much setting yourself up for a major destruction. I'm gonna prove that.
You can't retire out of the truth.
That's right.
You know, a lot of people that have gone into this truth and they fell back. They fell back into the world. Well, they still call themselves Israelites, but they don't do the work.
That's right.
You have to do the work. And if you got a job 6 days a week, hey, I mean, what about after work? You know, go pick a street corner, pick a spot in whatever city you're in, and drop the word. You have to drop the word.
That's right.
There's no getting around it. You know what I'm saying? It's dealing with your soul, like the brother said, your contract. And Moses, our forefather, told us, choose either life or death.
That's right.
So then, to bring it up to date with Yahweh Shah, the Lord, he sent out his apostles. So that was going to come back on the earth. That spirit of the apostles and the men of the Lord, the prophets, were always going to come back. The last days before the downfall, a very major kingdom. This is the last kingdom that shall fall. So we got to pick up where they left off. You know what I'm saying?
That's right.
They didn't leave off. They passed away to the spirit world. But now the Most High has woken up our people again. Like it says in Ezekiel 37 chapter, dry bones.
That's right.
With that breath, that's how the Lord speaking through us, the Bible.
Right, that's right.
You have something else?
Yeah, so back to the point I was saying earlier, right? When you come to this truth, right? It's a contract, man. But for those that fall out, all right? I'm going to show you what happens, man. This is 2nd Ezra 1:27. It says, ye have not, as if it were forsaken me, but your own selves, say Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shai, man. So if you come into this truth and you fall out, you didn't forsake Yahweh Bashim, you didn't forsake the Heavenly Father and His Son. You forsake yourself. Alright? And that proves that you are really originally in your past life, you are one of the scribes that were talking against Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shai. You are one of them that said free Barabbas and crucify him. All right. So for you guys that fall out of this truth, all right, may Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shai bring great destruction upon you. Man. All right. The scripture says that. Matter of fact, let me go to the scripture to prove my point. Finally, all right. Because you see, man, this a lot of you guys think this is a joke. This is not a joke, right? This is our life. You're putting our life on the line, right? Because scripture says, offer your bodies unto me as a living sacrifice, right? You gotta come out here on the highways and byways, and you gotta do the work, man. All right. Anyways, bear with me 1 second. You know, while I get the scripture to prove my point.
I'll try to get that on the camera.
Yeah, because a couple of minutes ago, there was a plane that passed by. There wasn't a couple of them. There's no clouds in the sky today. That's a damn chemtrail, bro. That's poisoning the people right there, bro.
Yeah,
that's population control. That's to block people out.
Yeah,
it
fucks with your brain.
That's why we gotta pray to the Lord, Yahweh Hashem, Yahweh Shah, protect us from that. There's no clouds in the sky today. A plane just passed by. They left the stream. a jet stream behind it, and now you have this shit hanging in the air right there. That's not a cloud. That's straight poison right there. That's good, the Most High plaguing these people, you know what I'm saying? Because they deserve it. They don't want to hear the word of the Lord, so we got to pray for ourselves, you know, and our occupants. You know, our families, you know, because our family's bugged out. So they don't know what's going on. Some people don't even look up in the sky. I'm sorry.
This is 2 Peter 2:21. For it had been better for them to not have known the way of righteousness, and after they have known it, to turn from the holy commandment, deliver it unto him.
That's right.
So again, man, you guys have fallen out of this thing, man. You guys are in deep shit, man. I'm just gonna say it like it is. You guys are in deep shit. Because when the Heavenly Father returns, because the scripture also speaks about they're gonna say, oh God, boy, Yahweh, Yahweh Shai, I put my feet to the plow, and this and that, but the Heavenly Father's gonna say, I didn't know you. Why? Because you took your feet away from the plow, man. Alright? The scripture clearly speaks about that. No man is fit for the kingdom if he puts his feet to the plow and look back. Alright? So like I said, man, this is serious, man. This is an unbreakable contract. Alright? This is life or death. Alright? We're out here for ourselves, ultimately. But we're out here to feed the flock, man. Like the brother said earlier, to bring the Israelites back into the marriage, man. Alright? Because this is a storybook of a father and his people, man. Alright? A husband and his wife. Matter of fact, I'm gonna get his precept also. This is, Hosea. Alright, there, give me 1 second. Alright, this is Hosea, right? I'm gonna go straight to the point. This is Hosea, verse 6 and 7, right? It says, therefore, behold, I will hedge up the way with thorns and make a wall that she shall not find her path, and she shall follow her after her love, but she will not overtake them, and she will seek them, but shall not find them. Then she will say, I will go and return to my first husband, for then was it better with me than now. All right, and what that's saying is saying that Israel, ultimately, they're going to return to the Heavenly Father, man. All right, because it was better. Because it was better. Because it was better. Like I said, because it was better with me then than it is now. Alright, because Israel, they went off, man. Deuteronomy 28, 6-8 on now, man. It tells you why we went into captivity and why we're in the condition that we're in, man. Alright? So these people started from Judah, right? They went off, man. They broke the laws. Alright? And because they broke the laws, they went off, they blasphemed the Lord's name, they worshiped all these other false idols. The Heavenly Father started that shit, man. All right? You know, but that was the point I wanted to make, man. You know, ultimately, man, the elect is gonna be saved, all right? And death to the two churches, man. That's all.
Yeah, so we got a precept.
The
brother was going into people that done the work and then fell back, you know what I'm saying? There's some people that did the work, they might have fell back, the Most High might have had mercy on them and brought them back into the work. There's some people that